ACES Workflow, Academy Color Encoding System. Big thing which is created to change the industry. Let's have a look into it. To start with, ACES is actually not a workflow at all. It's a linearized wide gamut color space that slowly becomes a standard in high-end production. You may be aware that at the moment sRGB is a standard almost in everything. In video world there is a Rec 709 that is a broadcast standard. There are many others, but we're talking about ACES. I won't be wrong by saying this is the future standard. It is created to help you optimize your workflow, and hopefully you will see all the benefits by the end of this video. If you ever worked on more or less big projects, you know how challenging it might be to work with rushes from several cameras, especially if the cameras were from different brands, like a mix of Red and Arri or Sony and Canon. What if I told you that you don't need to spend hours and hours trying to match several shots from different cameras to make them look identical, or that you can integrate CG elements into your live footage much faster and better? Well, that's what it is. That's what ACES does. Unifies color space and linearizes all the assets you're using in your project, which makes them significantly better behaved. In a nutshell, ACES is a linear representation of light from real world. Its purpose is to show the image as it was seen by the camera's sensor. Cameras are processing the linear response to light and turning the data into whatever you're shooting in, S-log, V-log, red-log, or other gamma curves. ACES is most effective with log or raw input. Log gamma curves are very clever and they're proven to be really efficient in post, but requires quite a lot of work. By bringing your footage into ACES, you're kind of skipping all the technical color grading work. Log profiles were created to extend the dynamic range. As a result, you have a very big dynamic range in post. You can restore all the highlights, all the shadows, and have greater control over the look of your shot. ACES takes this advantage even further by linearizing the footage and making the whole workflow quite a bit easier. With render engines, process is kind of the same, depending on your render settings. Since ACES is a very wide gamut color space, in order to work in it properly, you have to render your scene in ACES, not in sRGB or linear. But these days, not all render engines support ACES. For example, V-Ray, Arnold, Redshift support ACES, but my favorite Octane does not. If you think you could cheat it with LUTs in Octane, then it's not the same. It's not the same as rendering in ACES. My beloved Cinema 4D does not support it either. On internet I found couple of posts where users approached Maxon asking if ACES will be implemented at all, and Maxon replied that they have no idea what it is. The post was dated May 2018. It's a perfect example of how young ACES is. To make my Blender viewers happy, there is a way to properly emulate ACES in Blender. It's called Filmic Blender. Just saying. As I'm using Octane, the best option for me is to render EXR and then trying to convert linear space to ACES, which doesn't work perfectly all the time, but helps in some very specific situations like the one I showed you in my last tutorial about linear workflow. Couple of words about biased render engines. ACES helps to make light look more realistic in those engines, because by default the dynamic range in those engines is quite low and ACES expands it quite a bit. Octane is an unbiased engine and the light behaves like real world light straight away, so we don't have those problems other engines have. But still, it would be nice to actually render in ACES in addition to that and have that smooth, consistent pipeline. It's easy to overthink or overcomplicate all that stuff, but it's very straightforward, I promise. And same as linear workflow I explained in last tutorial, ACES is created to make your life easier. There are IDTs, ODTs, and RRTs. IDTs are input device transformers. Whatever is your input, whatever it was shot in, IDT will convert it to ACES. Then you would do all the work in ACES color space. Once everything is done, you will take your work and put it through ODT, which is Output Device Transformer. It takes ACES and converts it to whatever you need to deliver, back to sRGB, REC 709, REC 2020, or anything else. There is also RRT, which stands for Reference Rendering Transform, and it works in conjunction with ODT to ensure consistent look of the image across multiple platforms. But I think it's worth separate videos, so I'm not touching this one in details. So, by working in ACES, you're future-proof, because at any point in time you can come back and without having to redo absolutely anything, you can export in a new color space. It's like proceduralism coming to colors. When all the softwares that does not natively have all the necessary profiles, there will be an color manager called OCIO, and you have to download all the IDTs and ODTs yourself. I left the link in the video description, just download the archive, extract it somewhere where you will remember the location. Let's jump to Fusion. Luckily for us, Fusion has OCIO by default. I prepared some examples for today, and it's footage from two different cameras, A7R II and FS7. FS7 footage is shot in S-Log 3, A7R footage is shot in standard profile and also in S-Log 2. So import your footage in the Fusion, just a test thingy I made in S-Log 3. So in order to transfer it into ACES, we need to click Control Space and type in OCIO. OCIO color space. Connect it and drag it to our second viewer, so that we would be able to see the difference. Remember the archive I told you to download and remember the location. Hope you remember it. Click here and specify where is it that your ACES 103 config file lives in. And now in our source space dropdown we have a lot of options. Since I'm a very organized person, I know that I shot this in S-Log 3. So I'll just scroll, I will choose input Sony S-Log 3, S-Gamut 3, Cine, because that's exactly what my settings were. And output space I will choose as REC 709, because that's what I'm delivering in. Suddenly, you see that your scene looks normal, it's not washed out, you have normal contrast and everything. But it only works if you only want to transfer your footage from S-Log to REC 709, you're not actually working in ACES yet. So what I will do now is I will duplicate this node. In my IDT, I would set output space as ACES, and then I will connect it to the second node, make a preview out of it, and then second node, I will set my input as ACES CC. ACES CC that outputs to REC 709. And everything in between those two nodes will work in ACES color space. If I would add color corrector and bring up my waveform, now just pay attention to the waveform, how it behaves, all right? I will put these side by side later, but just remember that. And you see the difference. The waveform and all the colors are changing dramatically different. I tell you what, screw Fusion, all right? I'll show it properly in DaVinci. As a leader in colors, DaVinci have native support for ACES, of course. I already preloaded all the footages in here. Same stuff, but this time I have A7R II, S-Log 2, A7R III, regular profile, and then FS7 with S-Log 3. Now I will actually show you the whole point about ACES. So this is a regular DaVinci color space. If that would be my regular projects, what I would do first is I would go through every shot and manually do all the technical color grade to ensure the color and contrast consistency. And typically that process can take quite a lot of time. Okay, let's just reset all the nodes, all the grades. Now let's try ACES. And I will go to File, Project Settings. There you have Color Management tab and Color Science. Click it and select ASUS CC. ASUS input device transform, so here you would put your input data, whatever you shot in. My cameras are different, so I can either select S-Log2 and then manually assign S-Log3 profile to my FS7 shot, or I can select no input transform at all. Output device transform would be Rec 709. Look ugly at the moment, right? But that's because we didn't select IDTs. We will assign them manually. Go to your color grading tab, right click on the icon of the footage, and go to ASUS input transform and select your input that way. If I would go to my timeline view and play through all the rushes, you see that they look almost identical. So all the technical color grade is already done. And now we're working in ASUS here. One thing to remember about ASUS is that everything is quite a bit different in it. Let's have a look at this footage and its waveform. I'll quickly go back to the regular color space in DaVinci. There are some bright skies in there. Pay attention to the waveform. Everything from shadows to highlights are moving all together in regular color space. And now let's switch back to ASUS. Let's move the offset slider here. See how different the behavior is. As I mentioned, ASUS linearized the input and displays the image as it was seen by the camera sensor. Therefore, all manipulations feel more like changing the settings in the camera. That's not true, of course, it's just the analogy I use to describe the difference. You will need to get used to it. And finally, After Effects. After Effects is a bit painful for ASUS, but it's doable. First of all, you will need to install OCIO to After Effects. To do so, all you need to do is download the archive, the link is in the video description, and install opencolorio.aex to the program files, Adobe After Effects, blah blah, support files, plugins, and create a folder in there. Call it opencolorio and just drop that file in there. Now open After Effects, bring in your sample footage. Let's use FS7 one. Click on this 8-bit thing, set the depth to 32 bits per channel. Working space, choose ASUS CG. I don't know why, it just works better. And linearize working space. All right, let's create a new comp. Nothing happens, it looks like a usual footage. On all the footages that you import, you would need to right click, interpret footage, main, go to the color management tab, and click preserve RGB checkbox. Some footage, like in my case, wouldn't allow you to do that. In this case, just pre-comp this footage, so call it something like profile converted, because that's what we're going to do. In effects and presets search field, type in color profile. And this might be confusing, but I'll explain. You need to select your input profile as ASUS CG, because this is our scene's color space, all right? And select output to whatever your footage says right here. In our case, it's Rec 709. And we need to linearize input because our scene is linearized. I know it might be confusing, but here's what happens. We need to remove the confusion from After Effects. We needed to take this footage as Rec 709 and bring it to ASUS workspace. This converting process needs to be done. And that's what we did with this color profile converter. Now you notice that it's quite a bit different. And that's because After Effects is still managing some color stuff. A lot of color management happens inside of After Effects. But to fix that, you would need to click View and uncheck Use Display Color Management. Here you go. Okay, now it's time to bring this bad boy into actual ASUS workspace. Okay, click Effects, Utility, Open Color IO, OCIO. In here, I pre-installed that configurations folder in one of the locations, but you would click Custom and specify where your ASUS 103 folder is. And here we have it, input space and output space. And here we will do the same stuff as we did in Fusion. We will specify our input and we will specify our output. Output is of course Aces CG. Then what I will do is I'll create a new adjustment layer, which I will call Aces to output. Again, utility OpenColor.io, input space will be Aces CG, and output space will be Rec 709. And here you go. Now, in order to work in actual Aces color space, you would have to do all your work in between those two nodes. In between those two layers, sorry. Because that's where Aces color space is. The good way to check if you're actually in Aces or not is again waveforms. So I'll disable these layers and have a look how waveform performs. And I will just drag that exposure here. Have a look how it works without Aces. And let's enable Aces again. And this is how it behaves with Aces. Quite a bit different. To summarize, Aces, in my opinion, is future of the colors in the industry. I showed you how it drastically speeds the workflow, allowing you to almost skip the technical grade, match several cameras like with a one click. Unfortunately, I haven't showed you any CG stuff in Aces, but actually I did. I did it in last tutorial. Aces allowed me to sort my light passes problem. So more and more softwares and hardware manufacturers are now supporting Aces, and I think it's a game changer on a bigger projects when you have several cameras. You don't have to spend ages trying to match them. It's like linear workflow from our last tutorial brought to color grading. And I think in future it might make sense to show actual color grading process with Aces and maybe without, because the game changing benefits, they might not be as obvious from the first sight. I don't know, was it not? Let me know in the comments down below. For now, that would be it. See you soon. Peace.